So just to reiterate why in machine learning, we split the data between a training dataset and a testing dataset. So as you know, what we can do is here our dataset over here. And for some of it, what we want to do is we want to maybe take 20% of the data for testing. And rather than manually splitting the data, because previously what you can do is you can use function over here, which is train test split. What this function does is it lets you put in your data. So these are the x's and then this is the y values. So here, so you can see we said x is size, y is the price, and you can see here we are saying test size is we want 20%, and here this is just a random number. This is to randomly select some values, but every time we run this cell, then we want the same selection of values to be selected. So this 42 ensures that we do that. So, but the question becomes is why do we split between training set and testing set? Why do we do this? So I want you to imagine yourself where you in your own kitchen at home practice making cakes. If you make cakes and you case your cakes yourself, you're a brilliant baker and you are able to make the best cakes. But the actual result is you get going to your friends or out there in the public giving people tasters of your cake and saying, what do you think about my cakes? I know I'm very good, but what do you think? So those people that might be in your own kitchen, for example, your own family, they might go, you're a brilliant baker. But what you want to do is you want to save a few people separately. So maybe, you know, out of this data, keep two people separately and then ask them, what do you think of my baking skills? And this is exactly why we split the data. We let the model, the machine algorithms learn from this data. But in order to be 100% sure that the model is working, you keep some of the known data separately and you test based on that data, and the output that you get will determine how good your model is. So the basic purpose of testing essentially is the testing data is used to evaluate how accurate and how good your model is. Because if you use the testing data again, so let's say you use all of this data here in your testing, of course, it's going to be pretty good and then you're going to get very good results. Because if already seen this data, if you show some students the answers to the exam and then at the other end, you go, actually, they go 100%. The reason they go 100% mark is because they've already seen the answers. That's why you keep some of the data that you know is accurate. You keep it separate so that you can test your machine learning algorithm. So basically, you're hiding it from the computer algorithm, better than null about it. And that's what training set and testing set does.